always please stand? Welcome to the 76th Annual Commencement at Lake Region State College. We will now retire the flags of the diverse nations represented by our student body. You may be seated. Please be sure that your cell phone is in silent mode, but feel free to take photographs during the ceremony if you wish. Now I'm pleased to present Dr. Doug Darling, President of Lake Region State College.
Good morning. Let's try that one more time. Good morning. What a beautiful, brisk spring North Dakota day we've got for a commencement ceremony. Honored guests, graduates, students, faculty and staff, family and friends, on behalf of the faculty, staff, students, and administration, I'd like to welcome you to the Lake Region State College's 2018 commencement ceremony. Graduation day is both an end and a beginning for these graduates. It's the end of this portion of their educational experience, and it's also the beginning of a new career for some and a new educational experience for those transferring. It's an important day for these graduates and their families, and it's really great to see so many family members here today. Many of you have provided valuable support for these students during their work on degrees that they will receive today. Thank you for being here today to support these graduates and help them celebrate this milestone in their lives. It's my honor to introduce our representative from the North Dakota State Board of Higher Education, Mr. Mike Ness from Hazen, North Dakota. He has served on the State Board of Higher Education since initially being appointed on February 26th of 2015. He formerly served as superintendent of the Hazen School District, where he was employed for 12 years. Ness received his Bachelor of Science degree in Education from North Dakota State University and his Master's of Science in Education Administration from North Dakota State University. Ness has been involved in K-12 education as a teacher, a principal, a superintendent in the Verona, Stanton, Center, Botno, and Hazen school systems during the last 42 years. He brings a K-12 educator connection to the board, along with his vast knowledge and professional experience. He retired as superintendent of the Hazen School District on June 30th, 2015. Please welcome Mr. Mike Ness.
Good morning, President Darling, faculty, staff, family, friends, and most importantly, graduates of the Lake Region State College, class of 2018. On behalf of the State Board of Higher Education, I congratulate you all for your achievements. Since I became a member of the board, I have found special enjoyment in two opportunities and experiences in particular. One is visiting each of our state's unique campuses, and the second is being a part of the milestone event such as this graduation. Prior to becoming a member of the board, as Dr. Darling said, I was in K-12 education for 42 years. I worked in several communities around the state. I believe that each commencement ceremony serves an exclamation point in a job well done. This is time to look back on accomplishments, but more importantly, to look forward to the exciting opportunities ahead. This is also kind of a homecoming for me. This is my home area. I grew up in Tallinn, North Dakota, graduated from there, and then have gone on from there. I visited your campus many times, and I'm always so impressed with how well-kept it is and the pride that people have in this campus. I also love this area. I have spent many, many days and hours standing on the ice and in a boat out on beautiful Devil's Lake. I know that I'm not alone in the satisfaction of watching you move onto the next phase of your lives. Your family and friends, your professors and instructors, and many others who have fulfilled a role in helping you reach this moment are also very proud of you. It is time for you to think about the people who have been so important in your life and thank them. Take the opportunity today to thank the faculty and the staff who have worked with you, your parents and your family, and your friends. Today may be the last time that you will have the opportunity to visit with some of your friends. So thank them for what they have done for you. Reminds me of 2 weeks ago tomorrow, I came back to this area, came to Pekin, where most of you know where that is. It's a suburb of Tallinn. And I was there for a memorial service for a friend of mine who I went to school with, played ball with, graduated from high school with, went to college, and graduated together. I had not seen him since 1973. We went our separate ways. And I hadn't talked to him. And when he passed away in December, it just kind of made me think, what have I missed out? Not contacting him and visiting somewhat. So 2 weeks ago, I came back and I saw people that I hadn't seen in 45 years. It was an important day. This may be the last time that you will see some of the people you are graduating with, so please thank them and keep in touch with them. This big step can be an anxious one. As you move forward now in your career and life and become a part of the community and thrive in your own right, you'll find new challenges. Some challenges will be overcome by skills you've learned through your studies here at Lake Region College. Some of them will be overcome through what your family and friends have taught you, or through what you've learned by simply experiencing in and out of college. Some will be overcome by creativity. Some will be overcome through teamwork. But all challenges do have solutions, and each holds the promise of success. As you face these challenges, be confident. Look at what you've accomplished for yourselves today. You've dedicated yourself to years' worth of study. Throughout that time, there were likely moments of anxiety surrounding tests, assignments, group work, or course choices. But the decisions on those choices helped bring you to this point in your graduation. When you throw your mortarboards in the air to celebrate at the end of this ceremony and this phase of your life, and know that it's due to the same type of perseverance and hard work that will be required of you in the years to come, and you can do it. Thank you for placing your trust in our North Dakota educational system and in Lake Region College. We applaud your accomplishments and are confident that the education you've received will give you the edge you need to move forward. Your readiness to take responsibility for yourself has led to clear success for you. Thank you, class of 2018, and congratulations on a job well done.
Lloyd Halverson, Vice President of Academic and Student Affairs, will introduce our student speakers.
Thank you, Dan. Our first commencement speaker is Adriana Bibo, or Abba, as most of the campus calls her. She is from Malta, Montana. She played volleyball for the Lady Royals and has proven to be a natural leader. While on campus, she was elected as the president of the LRSC Student Senate, and she graduates today with her AAS degree as a fitness trainer technician, as well as her Associate of Science degree. She plans to transfer to the University of Minnesota Morris for pre-physical therapy and to continue her volleyball career. She is the daughter of Edward and Terry Bibo. Please welcome Abba to the podium.
LRSC administration, faculty, staff, distinguished guests, fellow students, family and friends, thank you and welcome. I'm going to be honest. Lake Region was not my first choice of a college to attend. I was going to attend a different college and not play volleyball. However, a couple of weeks before my high school graduation, I got a phone call from Bridget Graywater. She offered to let me come try out for the volleyball team and take a tour of the campus. I wanted to play volleyball so bad that I decided to go to Lake Region. But I had no idea the people here would be so amazing. Everybody I met was incredibly helpful and nice. They helped me to find the classes I needed to take and helped me to get into a program that I love with a degree that I will be able to use no matter where life takes me. This was not something that I was getting at the other colleges I was looking at. Lake Region made me feel like I mattered, not like I was just another number on a piece of paper. Since coming to Lake Region, I've had the opportunity to experience so many things I never would have had at a different school. I traveled to different states and cities, held positions of leadership and responsibility that I often felt like I would not be able to handle, but somehow I always did. And because of this, I've grown as a person and a leader. I even spoke at the Board of Higher Education about the LARC, and even though I was so nerve-wracked, I was afraid I would forget how to speak, Dr. Darling still believed in me and told me that I would be able to do it. And I did. I recently spoke on behalf of the student body at the ribbon cutting ceremony for the new Learning Commons. And now I can say I've spoken at a college graduation. However, one of the most important experiences that I received from Lake Region are the friendships with individuals from all over the world. These are people that have helped me through everything, from finals to boy problems. And I know that no matter where life takes us, I will always be able to phone them if I need advice or pick me up. I just wish I would have taken more time to get to know them. I think now that with too many of them, this will be my last chance to spend time with them. The time shows up a lot faster than you think it will. There's a quote from my all-time favorite book, All the Places You'll Go by Dr. Seuss. And the quote goes, I'm afraid you'll play lonely games. Games you can't win because you'll play against you. All alone, whether you like it or not. Alone will be something you'll be quite a lot. However, alone was never something that I felt while being here at Lake Region. Sure, I was homesick and stressed, and I often felt out of my comfort zone, but never did I feel alone. There's always been someone in my corner, no matter if it was a friend or a staff or faculty member that works here at Lake Region. I always had someone to talk to about anything that was going on in my life. Never did I envy another student at a different college or university because I knew that they did not have the kind of support that I have had while attending Lake Region. I wish I could name everyone that has had an impact on my life since coming to Lake Region, but they told me I only have 4 to 6 minutes to speak and it'd take me a half an hour to thank them all. But I must thank Dan Johnson for giving me a job at the Liquid Bean so I was not a totally broke college student, and Bridget Graywater for pushing me both athletically and academically. I remember the time she made us practice one drill for the whole 2-hour practice because we just could not get it. At the time, it seemed like a waste of a good practice, but looking back, the experience taught me to always do tasks right, no matter how long it takes, and the perseverance to finish those tasks. To Tammy Riggin for helping me find a career path that I enjoy immensely and that I can see myself doing for a very long time, along with all of my friends, Skylar, Sean, Cord, Grantley, and Johannes, for making me get out of my room these past couple of months to spend time with you. I'm going to miss playing basketball and football with you, along with kicking your butts in Mario Kart, though. I'm sure they will not miss that. A special thank you goes to Evan Stack for being my best friend and first friend at Lake Region. Thank you for always being there for me through the good and the bad. You'll always be my favorite roommate. LR has shaped me to be more responsible, outgoing, and organized. It has also helped me to become a better leader on and off the volleyball court. However, I never would have gotten the opportunity to attend Lake Region if it had not been for my parents. They are the ones that created the building blocks of who I am today. Without them, I'm sure I never would have exceeded at Lake Region as I have. They have always been supportive of my hopes and dreams, and even though they were a bit skeptical about the distance between Malta and Devil's Lake, they still supported my decision. I was always able to phone them to ask for advice or just to tell them about my day. They would always listen to my story or rant first, before sharing their day with me. I'm truly so grateful for everything they have done for me. I know there is really no way for me to repay them for everything they have done, but the best way I can think of to repay them is to continue to make them proud. As I look to the next chapter in my life, I am nervous for what is to come. However, I know that because of the experience, education, and life lessons I have learned at Lake Region, I'm prepared for anything that life may throw my way. I'm going to miss Lake Region and Devil's Lake enormously. The people that have come into my life since starting college have my heart. But because of those people that helped me through my 2 years here, I am ready for what is to come. Thank you.
Our next student speaker is Quentin Sears. Quentin grew up on his family farm near Minnewaukan, North Dakota. He graduated from Candu High School and attended Lake Region State College to continue his education and love of farming by enrolling in our Precision Ag program. Quentin enjoys farming, but also likes carpentry work, tinkering with vehicles, and spending time with his dog, Zoe. Quentin managed to work almost full-time at the family farm while also a full-time student. After graduation, he plans to take what he's learned here in the Precision Ag program back to the farm to continue working with his brother, his father, and his grandpa. Please welcome Quentin Sears.
Good morning, everyone. Today is a good day. As we all gather here today, friends, family, faculty, and my fellow graduates, I just want to say congratulations. We did it, somehow. Just kidding. Give yourself a pat on the back if you can reach it in these uncomfortable gowns and goofy hats. And after you do that, insert a sticky note into your brain to thank everyone that helped and supported you through this journey in life. College is a huge step in life. It's a stepping stone into the next chapter. Some of us come from far, others near. For some of us, this is our first experience. For others, it is not. Some of us are 20, others are 80. But at the end of the day, we all came here to Lake Region. Being a smaller school, I feel as if we're all a much closer group here. You pretty much know everybody by their nickname here at Lake Region, and I believe that is a good thing. Now, being a precision ag student, I was not on campus very often. I had a few classes here, and I really enjoyed my time. The teachers were awesome. They were all so friendly and really made learning fun. I really mean that. From University 101 to English 110 and chemistry, I had fun learning all because of the teachers. And who has fun learning chemistry? But in all seriousness, I really wanted to thank my chemistry teacher, Sean Prince, for putting up with all the ag kids, especially during 8 a.m. lab. All of the teachers were always willing to help on anything myself or anyone ever needed, and I think that speaks a lot about Lake Region. As for myself, like Lloyd said, I grew up on a farm 30 miles southwest of here by Minnewaukan. I have always shared the love of farming with my grandpa, dad, and two brothers, Spencer and Tyler. From day one, I knew that I wanted to be involved in agriculture for the rest of my life. After high school, I had second thoughts on what I wanted to do, so I actually took a gap year. I worked on the farm in the spring and fall, and then did carpentry in the winter with my uncle. Having all winter to think, I decided that I wanted to pursue a degree in agriculture, yet stay close to home so I could still be involved with the farm. I decided at the beginning of August 2016 that I wanted to go into the Precision Ag program here at Lake Region. I had a few friends tell me nothing but great things about the program, and they were not wrong. We're a close-knit bunch out at the Ag Center, and it made my personal college experience something I will never forget. I came to Lake Region not knowing anyone in my program, and they are all now lifelong friends, including my instructors. Myself, and I believe many others, are so lucky to have a program of this caliber so close to home. The materials, technology, knowledge, and experience in the program are tremendous. A lot of majors are mostly taught from a textbook along with labs and projects, but in ag, sometimes that is just not enough. You need hands-on experience along with people who have personally experienced what goes on in the agricultural world. And the Precision Ag program at Lake Region offers the best of both worlds. We are taught such a wide range of things, from the basics of Microsoft Word and Excel, to multiple mapping and prescription writing softwares, farm management, sales, soil science, crop scouting, skid steer training, and the list just goes on and on. It is truly amazing how many great classes Preston and Oybeck taught us in just 2 short years. Now, obviously, I am completely biased because that is my major, but I truly feel 110% prepared for either going back to my own farm or going to work a job out in the real agricultural world. I've been talking for a few minutes now, and you are probably all thinking, can we just go on with the ceremony and be done? Don't worry, I'm thinking the same thing. Before I walk off this stage, I'm going to try and inspire you with something I thought of while sitting on my couch at midnight, writing the speech the night before it was due. My good friend Will Ferrell once told me, when I was 10, I wrote an essay on what I would be when I grew up and said I would be a professional soccer player and a comedian in the off-season. Look at him now. No matter what you choose to do in your lives, just always try your best. There will be many ups and downs in your life, but no matter what, I want you all to follow your dreams. Will Rogers once said, even if you are on the right track, you will get run over if you just sit there. Whenever life feels like it's starting to go right, don't just stop at that. Keep pushing yourselves, and again, follow your dreams. Even though I don't know everyone here, I believe in every single one of you. You've made it this far with hard work and determination, and I can't wait to see where life takes you. Thank you all, and I wish you the best.
Thank you, Quentin. Now we have a special musical selection, The Climb, performed by our Lake Region student, Precious Rollins.
See it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost in no direction. My faith is shaking, but I gotta keep trying, I gotta keep. I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most. Yeah. Just gotta keep going, and I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on.
Thank you, Precious. Now, Vice President Lloyd Halverson will announce the recipients of a number of special awards.
Thank you, Precious. Just for a short introduction, Precious is a Lady Royal volleyball and softball player who loves music and was part of her band in her home island of Molokai, Hawaii. She is pursuing her liberal arts degree and plans to transfer to a four-year school to study biology. She is the daughter of Sean and Princess Kakahuna and has six siblings. If I could have Steve Shark, the Director of Student Affairs, join me on stage for the awards presentation. We have eight Who's Who awards to announce today. And I would like the seven of those eight awards recipients to come forward at this time. Heather Brown, Rick Drury, Evan Stack, Aaron Nelson, Emily Schaefer, and Nick Fassos, and Adriana Bebo. Stand in front of the recipients over there. Yep. front of the chairs. Each year, Lake Region State College recognizes the leadership and achievements of its graduates by recognizing them with the Who's Who Award. Students must be nominated by faculty or staff, with the winners chosen by a committee. The award recognizes students for achievements in the areas of scholarship, leadership, citizenship, participation in LRSC and community activities, and potential for future service. The names of these students are permanently inscribed on a plaque in our Hall of Fame. 8 students earned this honor. Our first recipient, please take one step forward, Heather Brown. Heather is probably one of the best known and most cheerful faces on campus. Her energy and enthusiasm know no bounds. As a member of LRSC Playmakers, she has worked on stage, backstage, and even in other venues to entertain and enlighten our audiences. She has twice been nominated by regional respondents to compete in the Irene Ryan Acting Scholarship Competition at the Kennedy Center American College Theater Festival. She also stepped into the role of president of the Playmakers Theater Club at a moment's notice. She has been active in building and acquiring props for shows and proven to be invaluable in makeup and costuming. Her accomplishments on stage resulted in her selection as this year's recipient of the Glenn H. Larson Memorial Drama Award. Her advisor says this: she is always positive, barely needs a light when on stage, as her generous spirit is brighter than any spotlight. Congratulations, Heather. Rick Drury, please step forward. Our next recipient is Rick Drury. Rick is from Atlanta, Georgia, and will be graduating with a simulation technology degree. Rick has been very involved on campus since the day he arrived. He served as a royal ambassador, as a resident assistant, and helped with our graduation video. During Rick's LRSC career, he was a great listener and always took time to talk with his fellow students, whether it was late at night or early in the morning. He also took up acting, something he had never done in the past, and performed in one of the many Playmakers productions. Rick has recently accepted an offer to become an IT technician right here at Lake Region State College. Congratulations, Rick Drury. Evan Stack. The third recipient is from Asquith, Saskatchewan, Canada, and came to Lake Region State College to play volleyball for the Royals. Evan was a student in our fitness trainer technician program. In addition to the excellence she displayed in the classroom, Evan served as co-vice president of Phi Theta Kappa's Honor Society, and she served as a resident assistant, helping supervise our residence halls. Evan was also selected as one of the 3 LRSC Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society members to be named to the governor's All North Dakota academic team. Evan plans on returning home to pursue a career as a personal trainer with the goal of entering a 4-year institution to get a degree in renewable resources. Congratulations, Evan. Next, we have Aaron Nelson. Aaron is from Devil's Lake and will be graduating with her Associate of Applied Science degree in Fitness Trainer Technician and an Associate of Science. She served as president of the Campus Crusade for Christ, co-president of the LRSC Soccer Club, and a member of the LRSC Chess Club. Aaron also helped train the Devil's Lake Fire Department, as well as the Lake Region State College Wind Technology students, to get ready for their physical careers. Aaron also spent the last 2 years reaching out and getting international students involved in the LRSC community. Aaron plans on attending UND in the fall, majoring in entrepreneurship with the goal of opening her own fitness business. Congratulations, Aaron. Emily Schaefer. Emily is also from Devils Lake, North Dakota. She came to Lake Region State College to play for the Lady Royals basketball team, as well as get a dual degree in liberal arts and fitness trainer. Emily is a four-time Mondak Conference Player of the Week, was named twice to the All-Region 13 team, to the second team All-Mondak Conference, first team All-Mondak Conference, and was an NJCAA Top 40 player. She was also selected to and participated in the NJCAA Freshman All-Star Game. Emily closed out her career as the number 18 all-time leading lady scorer for Lake Region State College. Emily excelled in the classroom too, definitely putting the student in student athlete. With a strong schedule of academic courses, she was named to the All-Mondak Conference academic team. Emily will be joining Valley City State University's women's basketball program next year and plans on majoring in math education to pursue a career in teaching. Congratulations, Emily. Nicholas Fassos. Nick is from Adelaide, Australia, and came to Lake Region State College to play basketball for the Royals. Nick was part of the South Australia State under 16, under 18, and under 20 teams. Since coming to Lake Region, Nick has been a two-year starter on the men's basketball team, co-vice president of Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, and has participated in many campus activities. Nick is a two-time academic all-conference, two-time NJCAA scholar athlete, and two-time president's list member. Nick was also selected as one of the three LRSC Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society members to be named to the Governor's North Dakota All-Academic Team. Nick plans on attending a four-year institution and majoring in engineering. Congratulations, Nick. Our commencement speaker, Adriana Bibo. Bibo. And president of the Student Senate. Bibo is no stranger when it comes to leadership. During her reign as president, ABBA helped coordinate campus information forums, community-wide information forums, and arranged for a student vote. President Darling took ABBA to the State Board of Higher Education meeting, where she testified in favor of a student fee to allow for the construction of a community wellness center. According to Dr. Darling, she was nothing short of absolutely impressive. She was also the co-president of Phi Theta Kappa, and she plans to transfer to the University of Minnesota Morris for a pre-physical therapy degree and to continue her volleyball career. Congratulations, ABBA. These award winners can now step off stage. Thank you and congratulations. Lake Region State College chooses one who's who student selection who demonstrated the most significant aspects of leadership, dedication, and service to Lake Region State College, and bestows upon them the Richard D. Kanoki Leadership Award. This year's recipient stands tall, both physically at just over 7 feet, and with his dedication to school, athletics, and participation in all things Lake Region. He is from Southampton, United Kingdom, and came to Lake Region State College to play basketball for the Royals. He was a member of Great Britain's under-20 European Championship team, which won the bronze medal in 2017. Since coming to Lake Region, he has submersed himself in the LRSC community, whether it's making s'mores for the first time or trying just about every activity on campus. In his second year, he joined Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society and became president, served as a resident assistant, and designed from scratch the Harry Potter escape room. He is a two-time academic all-conference, two-time NJCAA scholar athlete, and two-time president's list member. He also rounded out the final spot on the governor's All-North Dakota academic team and is this year's recipient of the Writing Excellence Award. Harvey, when he leaves Lake Region State College, will attend a four-year institution and plans to major in microbiology. Please help me congratulate the Who's Who Richard D. Kanoki Leadership Award winner, Harvey Barr. Thank you.
Jan Kurtz, President of the Community College Foundation, will now present greetings from the Foundation.
Good morning. This morning I'd like to address the 2018 graduating class of Lake Region State College. Congratulations, graduates. You are now alumni of Lake Region State College. On behalf of the Community College Foundation, we wish you much happiness and future success. The Community College Foundation was established in 1959 by local Lake Region leaders so that they could accept monetary gifts on behalf of the college to provide assistance to our students. Since that 1959, the foundation has been able to assist thousands of students with their financial needs while attending Lake Region. The board of directors is committed to good stewardship, and they work hard to direct support to the areas of the greatest financial need. Lake Region State College's motto is, "We change lives." And as you spent time here, I hope that we changed your life in a very positive way. As you go out into the world, whether it's on to more education or into the workforce, remember to keep LRSC on your mind and in your heart. Each one of you has in some way reaped the benefits of this institution, and I hope you're successful enough to remember to pay it forward to future Lake Region State College students through the Community College Foundation. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Jan. Well, it's my pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker today. Sarah Kuntz Wall is a native of Devil's Lake, North Dakota, and the daughter of Barb and Larry Zaradka. She graduated from Devil's Lake High School in 2007, and the following fall, she started her career at Lake Region State College, pursuing an Associate of Arts degree in Liberal Arts. During her time at LRSC, she served as a student senator and eventually student body president. She was president of the first president of our Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society on campus 10 years ago. Sarah also worked as an assistant in the registrar's office and as a tutor for LRSC. In 2009, Sarah was named to North Dakota's All-State Academic Team and a Coca-Cola Scholar National Finalist. She ultimately graduated from Lake Region in May of 2009 and then continued her education at North Dakota State University, where she graduated with a Bachelor of Arts degree in Political Science, magna cum laude. During her time at NDSU, she was active in their student government, serving as a student senator and student senate vice chair. Sarah was also named to the Dean's List and a member of the Phi Kappa Phi National Honor Society. Sarah received her Juris Doctorate cum laude from the University of North Dakota in 2014. After law school, Sarah served as a judicial law clerk for North Dakota's East Central Judicial District in Fargo. She then started working as an associate attorney for Smith, Forsberg, Schweigert, Armstrong, Moldenauer, and Smith in May of 2016. Sarah is licensed to practice law in North Dakota state and federal courts, as well as in Montana state courts. Sarah currently resides in Bismarck with her husband Jared, their yellow lab Watson, and their cat Jules. Please welcome our own Sarah Wall.
Good morning, everyone. President Darling, Registrar Johnson, State Board Representative Ness, Foundation President Kurtz, VP Halverson, Faculty Senate Representative Brown, Student Speaker Sears, student speaker Bebo, the distinguished faculty, staff, alumni, guests, special guests, and of course, the class of 2018. It is truly an honor to be here with you all today. Graduates, I commend you on your tremendous achievement. What each and every one of you has accomplished to be here today is something you should all be very proud of. Because no matter what happens in life, your education is something nobody can ever take away from you. My name is Sarah Wall, but those of you from the Devil's Lake area probably know me better as Sarah Kuntz, or possibly even Kuntzy if you guys remember me from my high school basketball days. I was born and raised here in Devil's Lake, graduated from DLHS, and I attended Lake Region for 2 years. Before I talk to you about a few things I've learned since leaving Lake Region, I would like to tell you a short story about the very first lesson I learned here. It happened before I ever took a class. It was the spring of my senior year of high school, and I had registered to start as a freshman in the following fall. I received a telephone call from Dan Johnson, the registrar, about a job opportunity as a student assistant in the registrar's office. Apparently, I had been recommended for the position by one of my high school basketball coaches that happened to work at the college, knowing that I needed a job. I don't remember the details exactly, but I believe I had an interview with Dan and Judy Lee, who was number two in the registrar's office back then, and they told me I would need to meet with Laurel Golding, the former head of student services. Well, for whatever reason, the 18-year-old version of me thought that this would be a much more casual occasion than Laurel had obviously been anticipating. I showed up in my typical high school apparel circa 2007, a hoodie, some holy jeans, and boy were they ripped, and some brown clogs. So, as can be expected, one of her very first questions for me in that interview was whether I thought what I was wearing was appropriate for an interview, and whether I intended to dress like that if I actually got the job. I'm not sure how I managed to muster a response, but I said no, thankfully, and informed her that I thought it was going to be just a quick chat rather than a formal interview. To this day, I still don't know why I hadn't thought more about what I was wearing that day than I did. However, in spite of this, I must have said something right, because they gave me a chance, gave me the job, and my life was never the same again. Excuse me. That job was my very first professional position. Introduced me to the wonderful staff and faculty on campus, and ultimately led directly to my involvement in numerous activities and other jobs on campus during my 2 years here. Also, I can safely say that I never wore ripped jeans to an interview ever again. I learned so much during my time here. I came here as a kid and left here as an adult that had a much stronger sense of self, maturity, and a belief that my future was bright. So for that, I am and will forever be truly indebted to this college. In preparing for my remarks today, I reflected back on my thoughts and feelings from my graduation day here at Lake Region. I remember feeling so proud because I was the first person from my family to graduate from college. And I couldn't wait for the next phase of my life to start at the University of Minnesota, be living in a big city, become an actuary, and get a fantastic job at some big company in Minneapolis. What I definitely didn't think about is what if it didn't happen exactly as I had mapped out? That's what I would like to talk about with you all today. The things that I wish I would have known when I was sitting exactly where you are now. One, to fully appreciate where you are in the here and now, even if it isn't exactly how you had planned. Two, to never stop finding ways to challenge yourself. And three, to always make time to take care of yourself and your well-being. There was a time in my life where literally all of my plans changed, but it turned out okay. It was shortly after my graduation day here at Lake Region. For many of you, this will happen at some point. You will have everything planned out to a T, but when you get there, things change, and you aren't even sure you actually want what you had planned. After graduating from Lake Region, I transferred to the business school at the University of Minnesota in Minneapolis, and I was going to become an actuary. For those of you that don't know, an actuary analyzes statistics to determine the risks of various actions, usually in the field of insurance. But to be honest, nobody really knows what an actuary does outside of probably Dan Johnson. The program I was accepted to was very competitive, and I worked hard to apply and be accepted. The only problem was that once I got there, I realized pretty quickly that being an actuary, or even working in the corporate business world, was not what I wanted to do for the rest of my life. Poor timing, I know. But I regrouped, and after some self-reflection, realized that what I actually wanted to do was find a way to help people, and that I could do that through my childhood dream of becoming a lawyer. So I transferred to NDSU at the end of my first semester at the U of M, switched my major to political science, and eventually attended law school at UND. I know a lot of people were disappointed in my decision, and there were so many times I felt guilty for letting down the people that had helped me get into that competitive business program. But what could have been a huge disaster turned into one of the best decisions in my life. I love my work, and I met my husband in law school. If I hadn't been willing to shift gears, I'm not sure where I would be right now, probably not speaking to you all. So that is why my first message today is to be happy with your life right now, even if it isn't exactly how you planned it. Growing up, I had some struggles, as we all do in one way or another. In my case, I came from a single-parent household where my mom worked a lot to take care of me and my younger sister. My father was in and out of my life as he suffered from alcoholism. So, to cope with not having what I thought was the picture-perfect childhood, I did what many kids do. Dream about the future. In elementary school, I would daydream about all the things I would do and who I would be in middle school. In middle school, I could not wait for high school and do all the cool high school kid stuff. In high school, I couldn't wait for college so I could be treated like the adult that I thought I was. At the end of college, I couldn't be out of there fast enough to start law school. And while in law school, I thought I couldn't have been more ready to be an attorney and practicing already. But when I finally started my first job as a practicing lawyer, I realized that I had reached my dream, but I had spent so much time looking forward to everything in my life that I didn't know how to be happy where I was currently. And once I achieved my career goals, I remember thinking, what's next? I realized then that I couldn't keep chasing the carrot. I needed to learn to appreciate where I was, or I would never be happy. So the first lesson is this. Don't wish away your today in hopes tomorrow will be better. You can never get right now back. This leads me to my next message for you, which is even though you should appreciate the present, don't ever stop finding ways to challenge yourself and grow as a person. Once I started working after law school, I struggled with not having constant achievement feedback, like tests and assignments to challenge myself with. I kept waiting for the next hurdle to clear to demonstrate some sort of progress, but what I didn't realize is that now that I wasn't in school, I would need to find ways to challenge myself that weren't built into my schedule. Rather than just considering my work work, I would need to treat each project as an opportunity for growth and as a marker of what I had learned thus far. So my advice to you all is to always find areas in your careers or your life outside of your career to challenge yourself, whether it be working towards a promotion or earning additional certifications or licenses, or even just having more success with each project you complete. I firmly believe that doing these things will enrich you in your life and your careers. My third message to you is the most important, in my opinion. No matter what is going on in your life, you always need to make sure you are putting your health and well-being first. This is something I wish I would have heard when I was sitting where you all are today. If I had been given a grade in this subject in college, I would have received a big, huge F. After high school basketball ended, I completely stopped working out. I only worked out here and there at various points in college, but it was never for more than a couple weeks at a time. I certainly never ate well. I was happy in college if I was full, and that's about it. I definitely never meditated. I never stopped to evaluate how I was doing on a personal level. And as long as I was succeeding in school and had a job, I thought I was doing everything that I needed to do. The most stressful time of a new attorney's life, outside of the bar exam, of course, is the first few years of practice. Well, during my first year, the stress hit me really hard. I was overwhelmed, losing confidence, out of shape, and eating fast food on a daily basis. My stress got so bad that I called my mom and asked her if I should go to the doctor because I was convinced I was having a heart attack. She calmly said no, I was just stressed, but that I needed to do something immediately to deal with my stress. I knew she was right, and I couldn't go on acting as though I were a machine that could keep going on forever without any maintenance. I started researching stress management, and the first thing I discovered was that I needed to get myself moving. Running, weightlifting, yoga, CrossFit, rec leagues with friends, any of them would work. I just needed to get my body moving to get out of my head. The second piece was nutrition. I discovered that one cannot just keep filling up with junk food and expect to have an optimal output. Third, I needed to take time to decompress every day, whether that was meditation, sitting quietly, or even reading a book for fun rather than for work. Finally, I learned I needed to make these things a priority and completely non-negotiable. Everything else would take care of itself if I was putting my health first. I remember the commencement speaker at my law school graduation, former North Dakota Supreme Court Justice Mary Mullen Maring, who coincidentally is also from Devil's Lake, talk a lot about work-life balance. I wish I would have taken the things she had told us to heart that day and implemented them long before I reached my stress limit. But I am so glad I learned those lessons before I burned out. So please, don't make my mistakes and underestimate the importance of balance and self-care in your life. Whether you are a graduate transferring to a four-year university, or a graduate going directly into the workforce, or anywhere in between, I cannot urge you enough to always put your well-being first. Trust me, everything else will work itself out. So in conclusion, I hope you all remember, one, to fully appreciate where you are in the here and now, even if it isn't exactly how you planned. Two, to never stop finding ways to challenge yourself. And three, to always make time to take care of yourself and your well-being. Congratulations on your accomplishments and your graduation today, and good luck to all of you in your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah. Will the members of the graduating class of Lake Region State College please stand? President Darling, on behalf of the faculty and the staff of Lake Region State College, it is with great pride and pleasure that I present to you the graduating class of 2018. Each candidate's record has been reviewed and certified by the college registrar as meeting the requirements for the diploma or degree to be awarded.
Based on the authority vested in me by the state of North Dakota, I hereby confer upon you your diplomas and degrees in recognition of completion of all the necessary requirements thereof.
Will the first row of graduates please come forward? The other graduates may be seated. Cindy Brown, assistant professor, will introduce the graduates.
Adriana Bebo, associate in science, liberal arts, associate in applied science, fitness trainer, technician. Quentin Sears, associate in applied science, precision agriculture. Brina Abrahamson, associate in science, liberal arts. Ryan Allen, associate in arts, liberal arts. Laura Anderson, associate in applied science, associate degree nurse. Nicole Grace Anderson, associate in science, early childhood education. Alyssa Armentrout, associate in applied science, associate degree nurse. Rochelle Aronson, Diploma, Early Childhood Education. Harvey Barr, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Shania Bursey, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Skylar Bergstead, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Carly Bow, Associate in Arts, Business Administration. Cedric Boone, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Brett Boudreau, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Tammy Richer, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Ariana Brox, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Nicholas Brooks, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Heather Brown, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Eliana Cooper, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Travis Clifford, Diploma, Automotive Technology. Shaylee Damon, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Brenna Deese, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Law Enforcement. Keenan DeVere, Associate in Arts, Business Administration. Sydney Dennis, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Sheila Dick, Diploma, Business Administration. Rodney Dragswolf, Associate in Applied Science, Automotive Technology. Richard Drury, Associate in Applied Science, Simulator Maintenance Technology. Tanner Elperding, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Nicholas Fassas, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Devin Flanders, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Dylan Frazee, Associate in Applied Science, Law Enforcement. Eric Gilbertson, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Jacob Hansen, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Janelle Hansen, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Kurt Hart, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Caitlin Hillebrand, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Ryan Hoffner, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Brianna Holtz, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Early Childhood Education. Blake Hoyt, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Law Enforcement. Nicholas Hoyt, Associate in Art, Liberal Arts. Bryce Hunt, Associate in Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Jaden Hunt, Diploma, Automotive Technology. Ian Jensen, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Law Enforcement. Ezra Johnson, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Landon Johnson, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Eric Johnston, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Andrea Jorgensen, Associate in Science, Practical Nurse, Associate in Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Megan Jorgensen, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Mary Kalal, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Melanie Camp, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Carly Cannelli, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Kaylin Jorzovic, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Early Childhood Education. Jocelyn Klein, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Dalton Knapper, Associate in Applied Science, Law Enforcement. Jayla Knudsen, Associate in Applied Science, Speech-Language Pathology Assistant. Callie Kaplan, Associate in Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Austin Kazette, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Rob Kucher, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Shania Lehammer-Cottier, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Derek Laudenbach, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Austin Lee, Diploma, Automotive Technology. Eric Liedahl, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Danny Lones, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Cherie Malakas, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Lane Miller, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Matthew Miller, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Joanna Moe, Associate in Applied Science, Early Childhood. Haley Manzabraten, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Donovan Moon, Certificate, Wind Energy Technician. Aaron Morstead, Associate in Arts, Business Administration. Aaron Nelson, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts, Certificate, Fitness Trainer Technician. Jossie Nelson, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Mackenzie Ness, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Jake Parsons, Certificate, Marketing. Preston Ryerson, Associate in Arts, Business Administration. Tyler Kenton, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Cheyenne Riley, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, American Sign Language and Interpreting Studies. Shannon Ripplinger, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Early Childhood Education. Jaylean Roberts, Associate in Arts, Business Administration. Therese Rowland, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Sarah Saylor, Associate in Applied Science, Administrative Assistant in Office Management. Grace Scanlon, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Emily Schaefer, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Fred Shemp, Associate in Applied Science, Automotive Technology. Derek Schweinler, Associate in Applied Science, Wind Energy Technician. Gina Self, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Kylie Skadsom, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Evan Stack, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Amber Stewart, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. James Streeter, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Jessica Swart, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Landon Swenson, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Drew Theilgis, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts, Certificate, Wind Energy Technician. Candace Thompson, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Emma Thompson, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Fitness Trainer Technician. Randy Thompson, Associate in Applied Science, Precision Agriculture. Dylan Veer, Associate in Arts, Business Administration. Crystal Waldo, Associate in Science, Liberal Arts. Jacqueline Walker, Associate in Arts, Business Administration. Alex Weston, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Zoe Willis Wildman, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Crystal Willisey, Associate in Applied Science, American Sign Language and Interpreting Studies. Michael Wood, Associate in Applied Science, Law Enforcement. Tai Yamamoto, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Anne Lorraine Yu, Associate in Applied Science, Associate Degree Nurse. Anna Ziegler, Associate in Arts, Business Administration.
Graduates, please stand and face the audience. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Lake Region State College graduating class of 2018. Everyone, please remain standing for the recessional. You are welcome to join us in celebrating our student success at a luncheon in the Student Union immediately following the recessional.